गुड आफ्टरनून सर, गुड आफ्टरनून मैम, गुड आफ्टरनून सर। थैंक
प्लीज हैव योर सीट दिव्या।
यू सर।
तो दिव्या, यू आर कमिंग, यू आर डायरेक्टली कमिंग फ्रॉम योर प्लेस और यू आर कमिंग फ्रॉम दिल्ली ओनली?
सर आई एम कमिंग फ्रॉम कानपुर।
कानपुर वाया ट्रेन वाया फ्लाइट?
सर बोथ एक्चुअली, कानपुर टू लखनऊ एंड लखनऊ टू दिल्ली वाया फ्लाइट।
ओके, फ्लाइट इज देयर। तो व्हाट इज द कोविड प्रोटोकॉल राइट नाउ?
Sir, in COVID protocol, we have to have the Arogya Setu app on and the vaccine confirmation code along with the social distancing, hand hygiene, and PPE kits, face masks.
Do you really feel that vaccine can work?
Sir, based on the empirical evidences, it is effective to a large extent to prevent.
What do you mean by empirical evidences?
Sir, the trial studies which are continuing, so it is not able to prevent the infection, but the disease mortality, death, and the worsening of the patient, that can be avoided.
ठीक है, तो इसको आपको शुरू में ही बोलना था दिव्या। ठीक है, अगर आपसे कोई पूछेगा कोविड प्रोटोकॉल क्या है, तो कोविड प्रोटोकॉल आपने सही बताया, उसके बाद आप बोलेगा कि क्या वैक्सीन प्रिवेंट कर सकती है डिजीज को। तो आप बोलोगे सर वो प्रिवेंट अभी नहीं कर सकती है सच, कोविड तो आपको हो सकता है, बट यस इट कैन प्रिवेंट द मोर्टलिटी इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस। उसी में आप एड डाउन भी कर सकते हो कि कोविड के वायरस में आगे स्ट्रिंग्स होते हैं, तो वो स्ट्रिंग्स को क्या कर देता है, डैमेज कर देता है, इस तरीके से आप बोल सकते हैं। ठीक है, चलो आगे चलते हैं। तो यू आर फ्रॉम उत्तर प्रदेश?
यस सर।
व्हाई उत्तर प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट प्रोवाइडिंग द एक्चुअल इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द कोविड एंड व्हाई इट इज अंडर द इंटेंस क्रिटिसिज्म? डू यू फील दैट इट इज द रियलिटी और जस्ट अ मीडिया फेक न्यूज to defame the UP government?
Sir, I believe that the problem is real and there has been undercounting. Some reasons are bona fide that there is a lack of collecting data capacity within the state, especially in the rural areas. And some are malafide reasons also, which one could think of because of vested political interest. My state is going in election in the next year, and this will not seem good on the face of the government during the campaigning. So it is a denialism also mixed with a lack of scientific commitment to scientific truths.
Question kya tha Divya?
Sir, about the handling of the COVID and the media news, is it right or wrong?
तो मेरा मेन क्वेश्चन ये था कि जो डाटा आपकी गवर्नमेंट दे रही है कि वो सही दे रही है या उसको सप्रेस करके दे रही है ना, तो ये बड़ा ही डिप्लोमेटिक क्वेश्चन है, बिकॉज गवर्नमेंट इज इन्वॉल्व्ड, एवरीबॉडी इज इन्वॉल्व्ड, आईएएस ऑफिसर मेजर टास्क इज टू प्रोवाइड द इन्फॉर्मेशन। तो इसको हम थोड़ा सा डिप्लोमेटिकली बोल सकते हैं, इतना स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड की जगह। ये सर, द डाटा कलेक्शन प्रॉब्लम इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ होल इंडिया, नॉट ओनली उत्तर प्रदेश। लार्जर द स्टेट, मोर डिफिकल्टीज इन जनरेटिंग द डाटा। सर, for data we are dependent upon parastatal bodies, municipalities, even the state health department and district health departments. Even sir, it is upon the individual officers of the district whether they can provide the accurate data or not. So sir, according to me, there has been a deficiency in data collection, assimilation and dissemination problems.
Yes sir.
So sir, death is there, everyone is knowing, but actual figure is not in our hand only because death certificates are not providing properly, as it is a responsibility of municipalities. Some officers to prove themselves in front of the eyes of the chief minister or the secretariat office that they are doing well, they are intentionally suppress the data. And sir, maybe some media is working sometime in favor of government, sometime against the government, as we all are knowing. Itna simple answer doge. No next election, nothing, you should not speak anything politics. Yes, administration sir. Se related hi deal karna.
Yes,
sir. Municipality,
huh? Then I should talk about it, some district magistrate to be in favor, try to suppress the data. So I should twist it in that direction.
हाँ बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, यही तो मैंने सारा बाहर जो है ना चीफ मिनिस्टर पे नहीं डाला, मैंने डाल दिया अलग अलग लोगों पर, सच्चाई भी है।
Yes,
my students, my friends are working in Uttar Pradesh, and so many of them want to prove that they are the best DM. That's why they themselves are suppressing the data. they are restricting the media person to enter in their districts, and they are saying our district is almost COVID free, but actually it is not a thing. So ये हमारा perception बन गया कि Yogi is like a Hitler and dictator, he is not giving the data, but Yogi is dependent upon all the bodies. हमें उनके ऊपर work करना, उनके ऊपर बात करनी है, और कोई भी election, pre-election, any agenda, इन सब को छूना ही नहीं है, इनको अपनी talks में नहीं लेके आना है.
Yes, sir.
आपको सिर्फ एक ही चीज पर जोर देना है, डाटा कलेक्शन, डाटा assimilation, क्लासिफिकेशन एंड dissemination प्रॉब्लम. क्लियर?
Yes,
चलो.
तो यू आर फ्रॉम उत्तर प्रदेश है ना. When we are moving from Western Uttar Pradesh to the Eastern Uttar Pradesh, there has been a change in culture, economy, and society. Tell me two points regarding the change in this three dimension.
So, culturally, the influence of different cultures from the Punjab and Haryana that is higher.
I'm talking about Western Uttar Pradesh to Eastern Uttar Pradesh.
Yes, sir. So the culturally they are a little different because in Eastern Uttar Pradesh it is more in touch with, for example, the language is different, cuisines are different, and the festivals are different. Whereas in Western Uttar Pradesh, the influence of Punjabi and Haryanvi culture is more. So second, in terms of economy, the Western Uttar Pradesh is more affluent because of the benefits from Green Revolution and also the agglomeration economy effect of the NCR region. Whereas in Eastern Uttar Pradesh, it is largely dependent on agriculture, which is in under distress. There is also rural distress, and lot of seasonal floods are there also. And sir, socially, I think the Western Uttar Pradesh, because of its affluence and more prosperity, now witnesses a skewed sex ratio, and there is also gender equality aspect is also a problem there. And sir, in Eastern Uttar Pradesh, though these issues remain, but there are issues of which are common to both the areas, like gender-related crimes and more nexus between the politicians and bureaucrats, which is affecting the overall UP economy society.
देखो, मैं यूपी से हूँ, मैंने एक सर के क्वेश्चन फेस किए हैं, तो आई कैन टेल यू द वेरी गुड आंसर. ओके, इफ एनीबडी इज आस्किंग व्हाट इज द कल्चरल डिफरेंस, देन यू कैन से सर, वेस्टर्न बेल्ट इज मोर एग्रीगेरियन इन नेचर, देयरफॉर पैट्रियार्की आर इन देयर ब्लड राइट नाउ, तो दे आर मोर पैट्रियार्किकल देन द वेस्टर्न, दैट इज द ईस्टर्न उत्तर प्रदेश पीपल, दिस इज द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द कल्चर. बट बिकॉज ऑफ सर मोर मनी एंड द मोर इनकम एंड प्रोस्पेरिटी, वुमेन in the Western Uttar Pradesh are more empowered, more educated, and more work oriented than the Eastern Uttar Pradesh, only because the money is providing the good advantage in form of education and health, which directly impact not only men but also the women. Is tarah se aap culture usme bata sakte ho. Theek hai, economic front par 90% of GDP of the whole Uttar Pradesh are coming only from Western Uttar Pradesh and some part of the Central Uttar Pradesh, particularly Kanpur Lucknow belt. The Western Uttar Pradesh is providing the agriculture, which is mainly belong to sugar cane. While we are moving to the Eastern Uttar Pradesh, the agriculture mainly belong to fruits, pulses and some rice. This is the second important, that is the difference economically.
Yes.
And that is society wise. So in society wise, the overall birth rate, death rate, MBR, MMR, other things are improved on the Western Uttar Pradesh side, but not on the Eastern Uttar Pradesh side. 2.1 TFR we achieved almost in districts of Western Uttar Pradesh than the Eastern Uttar Pradesh. Even the poverty is more in the Eastern Uttar Pradesh than the Western Uttar Pradesh. On some logical lines, you can develop this thing. Okay, Divya, we are giving you the opportunity to serve as a DM. In which part of Uttar Pradesh you like to be served? Which part you choose? If we are giving the option, choose for the developmental work in Uttar Pradesh. Which area you want to choose and why?
Sir, I would like to focus on the Bundelkhand region as well as the Purvanchal region of Uttar Pradesh, because both the regions have lower socio-economic indicators, and administration will have a lot of work, thought and social innovations space to do to better the life of the people there.
Bundelkhand region of Uttar Pradesh comprising of how many districts? Name the districts in the Bundelkhand region.
सर एग्जैक्ट नंबर आई एम नॉट अवेयर बट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स आर मिर्जापुर एंड
You want to serve in Bundelkhand and you want to join the districts. It's really, really amazing thing, surprising thing.
Sir, Banda, Jhansi, Lalitpur.
Purvanchal comprising of Lalitpur and other things are not there. Please tell me, Eastern Uttar Pradesh is comprising of how many districts?
Sir, number I'm not sure, but districts I can tell. Like Gorakhpur, Varanasi, Allahabad, Devariya, Baliya. And Ghazipur, sir, these many I can recollect right now.
आपको डिस्ट्रिक्ट बतानी चाहिए, ठीक है? Now please tell me what are the three problems of Bundelkhand area? Three core problems of Bundelkhand area.
Sir, it is a mineral rich region and the land is not fertile. There is also a water crisis.
Tell me two minerals which are available in Bundelkhand.
Sir, the potash and the glass sand and so these two at this point I can recollect. There are 3-4 more minerals there.
Is uranium is available in this area?
Yes sir, I think uranium is also available in a small quantity.
Which district? Recently you heard about Uttar Pradesh government negotiated with the Madhya Pradesh government and they solved the issue regarding Ket Betwa link. Tell me what are the three benefits which Uttar Pradesh as a country will get, as a region will get through this Ken Bitwa link?
Sir, more water security to the drought-prone region in that place and irrigation potential.
And what exactly is the loss?
Sir, loss is tremendous of the wildlife, biodiversity and a lot of area will be inundated with the water.
Any other loss?
Sir, there is also...
Cost of this project is very high, maybe. The cost of this project is very high in consideration of their consequences and outcomes. Enough?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And even then, why we are going with this project? What is the reason?
Sir, river interlinking is one of the mechanisms we are deploying to make sure that water management is proper because in our country, we have water, but the management has been a challenge. So this is a step in that direction. I will say it is a bold experiment and we'll see how it pans out for us.
Theek hai. You are from Kanpur?
Yes, sir.
You ever heard about Lal Imli?
Yes, sir.
Lal Imli brand. What is Lal Imli?
Sir, Lal Imli is a composite textile mill, mainly focused on the worsted and wool fabrics during the, for instance, the colonial era. As of now, it is only under 5% utilization.
What is the reason behind the completely shutdown of this type of firms in Kanpur? Earlier, Kanpur was considered as Manchester as a north, the Manchester of the north. But now, textile industry, mainly woolen textile industry, are on decline. Yes. Can you tell me some reason?
So there are multiple reasons. First is that the textile business owners who accrued their profit from their textile businesses did not reinvest in the technology upgradation as well as the skill upgradation and invested in some non-textile sector. So second is when because of losses, these mills came into direct government control. There were large scale corruption and a nexus between contractors and the administration. So third is the policy discontinuity. When the textile and handloom policy came around 1980s, it gave incentives for power looms as well as decentralized production. Whereas in Kanpur, we have the composite mills. And so lastly, it was the trade unions, which though forwarded the cost, but they later got divided on the communal as well as caste lines. So because of all these, sir, primarily these four factors, there's a decline in the organized textile business in the Kanpur.
As per the geographical survey, India is having good amount of population of sheep and the goats and other type of animals. Even then, we are not in a condition to produce good amount of wool from our own resources. According to you, what are the reasons behind this?
Sir, I am not very sure about it, but
Divya,
I can
talk with you. मैं 200 नंबर दिलवा सकता हूँ, पता है मुझे तुम्हारा प्रॉब्लम समझ में आ रहा है थोड़ा थोड़ा बेटा। एक तो है ना, थोड़ा थियोरेटिकल हो, है ना, थोड़ा चीजें बना के बोलने आनी चाहिए और थोड़ा एडजेक्टिव के वर्ड यूज करो, लाइक ट्रेमेंडस प्रॉब्लम. अब जैसे बुंदेलखंड में टक गए और जैसे कानपुर टेक्सटाइल मिला एकदम खुश हो गए, सर देयर आर सो मेनी ट्रेमेंडस प्रॉब्लम. सीधा बोल दो देयर आर प्रॉब्लम्स लाइक 1, 2, 3, 4. एडजेक्टिव यूज नहीं करो, ये तुम्हारा एक्साइटमेंट दिखाता है. ठीक. अब अगर कोई तुमसे पूछ रहा है कि इतनी सारी वूल है, शीप है, सब कुछ, इंडिया इज द लार्जेस्ट पॉपुलेशन ऑफ शीप इवन देन, व्हाई, तो आपको बोलना चाहिए सर वी आर अ ट्रॉपिकल कंट्री.
Yes,
and the overall consumption and demand of the wool is very less. And during the climate change, it is further reducing. Sir, earlier during my parent times, the winter are of around 2 to 3 months, but now it is just of 15-17 days. Dusra, sir, quality. Quality of our sheep are not good. That's why we are dependent upon New Zealand and Australia and Merino sheep.
Yes, sir.
आपके एक लिंक को दूसरे लिंक के साथ चेक करेंगे कि इफ यू आर गुड इन लाल इमली, इफ यू आर गुड इन कानपुर, देन यू शुड बी गुड इन, व्हाई वी आर नॉट हैविंग गुड कंजम्पशन ऑफ वूल. आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग माय पॉइंट? और उन तीनों डायमेंशन में आपको एक कोरिलेशन सिंपलिसिटी के साथ बनाना है और वो हम आपके लिए पूरा बनवा के देंगे. वेट एंड वॉच. क्लियर? दिव्या, राइट नाउ गंगा इज इन द न्यूज एंड वी ऑलवेज टॉक्स अबाउट दैट गंगा क्लीन प्रोजेक्ट्स एंड द मिशन गंगा प्रोजेक्ट, नमामि गंगा प्रोजेक्ट एंड सो ऑन. नाउ गंगा काउंसिल देयर एंड सो मेनी ब्ला 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 थिंग्स आर देयर. उत्तर प्रदेश इज प्रोवाइडिंग द लार्जेस्ट एरिया विद इन द गंगा रिवर कैचमेंट एरिया.
यस सर.
टेल मी इफ एनीबडी रियली वांट टू इंप्रूव द क्वालिटी ऑफ द गंगा रिवर, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली वन कैन डू और गवर्नमेंट कैन डू?
सर, first at the psychological level, one has to bear in mind that like how London dealt with its Thames pollution over a course of 60 years, that it is a major humongous project and it will take time. So sustaining the momentum of a large campaign like Namami Gange is very important. Sir, apart from this, I believe newer technologies like surface cleaners, which are deployed in other rivers also on a massive scale, can be done. So thirdly, what I felt was inter-agency coordination challenges. For example, Kanpur Jal Nigam, State Pollution Control Board, and the Tanneries Forum. So there is a lack of there is also information asymmetry, lack of proper communication that can be dealt with the better communication measures. And so lastly, community should not be just an observer, but an active participant. And this we can do through various methods, like we already have Eco Task Force engaging the school kids, Ganga Quest, Ganga Anthem, Ganga Yatra. Sir, it has to go on a sustained basis.
So, ये सब तो है हमारे देश में, ये सब हो रहा है जो तुमने बताया, सब हो रहा है, तब भी गंगा क्लीन क्यों नहीं है? We all are having all this thing. ये जो तुम्हें इंफॉर्मेशन पता चली, ये तो हो रही है, that's why it is in your mind. Even then, Ganga is not clean. Why? And why and how we can do the cleaning of this Ganga?
So I think the people who are not affected by unclean Ganga has to be equally participating in this.
People are dependent upon governance. If you saw the history, people mind were crafted and modified by the government and the governance.
Yes, sir.
So how people is responsible regarding the cleaning of Ganga?
Sir, we are all the stakeholders, be it the government.
Yeah, we all are the stakeholders. So many people improved it. I myself and my friends and so many people are not putting anything in the Ganga right now. Even then, problem exists.
Yes, sir.
Then?
Sir, everybody will have to be Ganga sensitized. So from the schools to colleges, IIT Kanpur is there. And from education, health, everybody has to be, sir, sensitized on this on this issue. And
especially, अभी तो नहीं हो रहा दिव्या, तब भी नहीं हो रहा है. Sensitized तो हैं. IIT Kanpur को हमने पूरा प्रोग्राम दे रखा है अंडर द उन्नत भारत अभियान. इवन देन, चलो रुक जाओ, वो तुम्हें इस पर खूब ग्रिल करेंगे तुम, क्योंकि आंसर का कोड नहीं पकड़ रहे हो. उन्होंने तुम्हारे को अपॉर्चुनिटी दी. पूरे आंसर में दो चीजें मुझे अच्छी लगी. फर्स्ट इज लंदन मॉडल जो तुमने स्टार्ट किया, बहुत अच्छा था, यही से पिकअप करना चाहिए. लेकिन इसके बाद तुमने पेस छोड़ दिया, तुमने वो बताया जो हो रहा है. हमने तुमसे पूछा क्या करना चाहिए, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली वी कैन डू. तो तीन चार चीजें हमेशा याद रखो कि सर, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी कैन कंसिडर दैट वी आर नॉट हैविंग दैट टाइप ऑफ सिस्टम, इवन टेक्नोलॉजी टू क्लीन द गंगा. देयरफॉर वी शुड टेक द हेल्प ऑफ जर्मनी, वी शुड टेक द हेल्प ऑफ लंदन, यूके, विदाउट एनी टाइप ऑफ शाइनेस, बाय इनवाइटिंग देम दैट दे शुड डू द सर्वे एज वेल एज प्लानिंग. And even we can give the tender to the companies who are responsible regarding the cleaning of Rhine River, the world most polluted river before 10 years. Clear? Pehla solution aap ye doge ki sir, hume Germany ko invite karna chahiye. नंबर टू सर, इन इंडिया बैंक्स आर वेरी सक्सेसफुल. इफ वी आर वॉचिंग बैंक्स एंड अदर इंस्टीट्यूशंस आर वेरी सक्सेसफुल बाय एंड लार्ज इन कंपैरिजन टू अदर इंस्टीट्यूशंस बिकॉज दीज इंस्टीट्यूशंस आर हैविंग द रेगुलेटरी बॉडीज. तो वी आर फीलिंग सिक्योर. We are not now hesitate to put our money, and even some problem is there, it can be resolved within 12 hours because of ombudsman. Yes or no? So, sir, according to me, regulatory body should be there. So, in spite of coming with different programs from Rajiv Gandhi till now, Ganga Action Plan to Namami Ganga, we should go with now regulatory body. So, on the line of PFRDA, RBI, IRDA, we should also provide Ganga Regulatory Authority. The work of this regulatory authority is to supervise and monitoring the work. And if the work is not up to the mark, penalty imposition should be there on the different stakeholders, including municipalities.
Yes.
Sir, third, municipalities are under power administratively and financially. Sir, Kanpur drainage was blocked only to highlight to the Prime Minister it is not working and not dumping the waste untreated water to Ganga Sismau drainage. But after 24 hours, it again start draining good amount of sewage into the Ganga River. So there is a need to empower the municipality that 90% sewage they can dump only after the treatment. Without treatment, they cannot come. Automatically, we can clean the river Ganga. And sir, if you asked, we can try that all the hydropower projects which are restricting the water should convert into the river run project. Minimum ecological flow should be ensured. If we are doing this thing in the preliminary part, we are successfully control the river Ganga, and then like Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, we can move towards Swachh Ganga Abhiyan for the attitudinal change of all the stakeholders in a progressive manner.
Yes, sir.
मुझे बताओ तुम्हारी अप्रोच में और मेरी अप्रोच में क्या डिफरेंस था?
Sir, tangible, doable points.
बस तो आपको इसी पर ज्यादा जोर देना है दिव्या इस बार, और मैं आपसे प्रॉमिस करता हूँ आप 200 नंबर से ज्यादा लिखे आओगे. ठीक Divya, what are the five industries in the Uttar Pradesh which are making the river Ganga dirtiest river? Name the five industries.
Sir, leather industries, the textile dyeing plants,
okay.
Fertilizer industries,
okay.
And sugar industries also to some extent. And so apart from this, the agricultural runoff, I think, is also a major problem.
Agriculture runoff is also a major problem. ठीक है. What is the agriculture runoff consequences to the river Ganga?
Sir, it leads to nutrient pollution because of excessive potassium and nitrogen.
But it can damage the river only when it is having stagnated water. If the water is enough flowing, then it cannot contaminate any river of the world.
Sir, ecological flow in the Ganga gets low because of the high level of damming on the upper reaches.
Okay, I am talking about industry or agriculture.
Sir, though both are responsible, but
I asked the industries specifically, or I also included agriculture.
Sir, your question was pointed towards industry only.
Bas, so your answer should be industry focus only. मैं सिखाऊंगा वीडियो में बार बार. कभी भी सीमाएं नहीं तोड़नी है. इंडस्ट्री पूछे पांच इंडस्ट्री खटाखट बता दो. पेपर इंडस्ट्री, फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री, लेदर टैनिंग इंडस्ट्री, टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्री एंड शुगर इंडस्ट्री. दिव्या, यू हर्ड अबाउट जीरो लिक्विड डिस्चार्ज कॉन्सेप्ट टू क्लीन गंगा?
यस सर.
व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय जीरो लिक्विड डिस्चार्ज?
सर, इन दिस मेथड वी टैंक in one of the tanks the excessive salt will be taken out, in another tank the solid particles they are taken out, and then some water is evaporated and that condensed water is used to feed back again as a clean water, and so therefore no water gets out, and using the evaporation or these mechanical methods.
Do you heard about new water and the clean water, new water and the gray water concept?
Grey water, I am aware, but not the new water.
Okay, what do you mean by grey water, and what is the use of grey water?
The grey water comes out from the household consumption, for example, the kitchen work, and can be reused after treatments.
Okay, very good, Divya. New water is the concept which National Mission for Sustainable Urbanization is using from Singapore. when we convert the potable water from the used water, that is known as new water.
Yes.
And grey water use are so many: fire extinguishers, gardening, agriculture, and even for the this thing flushing purpose in the toilets, we can use the grey water. तो ये सब आपसे पूछ सकते हैं वो अच्छे से, है ना। अब आगे चलते हैं, थोड़ा सा तुमसे और थोड़ा इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन पूछते हैं। इंडिया सेज दैट द अपकमिंग ग्रोथ और द 5 trillion इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ कैन कम टू इंडिया थ्रू पोर्ट लेड डेवलपमेंट। व्हाट एग्जैक्टली डू यू मीन बाय पोर्ट लेड डेवलपमेंट?
Sir, when ports are developed, there is a multiplier effect on the surrounding regions. It connects with the hinterland. So there is better demand and supply. There is better infrastructure. Jobs are created. Investment gets attracted to this region. Exports are boosted. So because of this, the economic indicators and gradually the social indicators will also improve.
Anything else? What do you mean by hinterland?
There are the regions in which the raw materials move towards the ports, and also the finished goods which is imported in these areas gets back to the hinterland.
Bahut simple batana hai Divya. Sir, hinterland means the serving area of any port.
Yes, sir, that is more
right. Yeah, koi baat nahi, sikhoge dheere dheere. What do you mean by break o bulk term? Break o bulk term.
Sir, I have not heard about this concept before.
देखो, यूपीएससी ने पूछा है दो बार ये मेंस में। सिंगापुर इज अ क्लासिकल एग्जांपल ऑफ ब्रेक ऑफ बल्क टाउन। इसके अंदर बड़े बड़े शिप आएंगे, आपके सिटी पर गुड्स उतारेंगे। यू कैन पुट दैट गुड्स इनटू योर बिग बिग वेयर हाउसेज एंड गोडाउन्स। नाउ द स्मॉल शिप कैन ट्रांसफर दिस गुड्स टू द नियर बाय कंट्रीज एंड अदर पार्ट ऑफ योर कॉस्ट। वी आर नाउ ट्राई टू मेंटेन वधवान पोर्ट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र एंड वजिंजम एज अ ब्रेक ऑफ बल्क टाउन ऑन द लाइन ऑफ सिंगापुर। Okay, what are the major three problems of the Indian ports right now?
Sir, port governance is a challenge because the government control is leading to a large level of inefficiency. Second is about the turnaround time and their drought and depth, because of which large vessels cannot come in. And sir, third is because they are not dealing with the large container ships or cargo, so the economies of scale is also missing.
There are some other problems of ports also. Berthing facilities are the problem.
Yes, sir.
Technology and the robotics, and we can say the automation of the ports is another problem. तो इस तरह की चीजों को थोड़ा सा बताओ। हमने एक port का answer discuss किया था, मैं share कर दूंगा group पर। So many things which I am asking, I can share on the group in our links, है ना, जिसमें से आप पढ़ सकते हैं। ठीक है दिव्या, we focus more on the physical infrastructure, but we are lacking in the social infrastructure. What, according to your own thinking, what exactly are the reason that we are less focusing on the social infrastructure than the physical infrastructure? Why these discrepancies?
Sir, I think it is a from a political level, there is a misguided policy approach, because I think in a country which is about to reap the going to reap the demographic dividend, social infrastructure is very important. But because we are not being able to attract good investment from other countries, our ICOR rate is very high. The government has been focusing on the physical infrastructure in a hope that we will have better per capita GDP, and then we will focus on social infrastructure, or maybe with the help of PPP.
There is a report of Oxfam. You heard about Oxfam?
Yes, sir.
Oxfam is releasing the report regarding
the inequality, sir.
You heard about Thomas Piketty?
Sir,
famous French economist.
Yes, sir, I remember he has talked about the levels of rising inequality in the world.
Recently, they talk about parasite of inequality damage the Indian economy and society post COVID. What exactly do you mean by this statement?
Sir, post COVID, if you look at the shares of, for instance, digital services like Baiju, so it has grown from $5.5 billion to $10.5 billion. So, and the context intensive services have really not been able to recover well. and the digital services have recovered. And sir, second very important point I think is the unorganized sector has been hit very hard. And this is very disproportionate and leading to further widening of inequalities. And their market share is now picked up by the organized sector.
Then what do you mean by this parasite? Parasite? What exactly is a parasite word? What exactly is the biological meaning of parasites?
So somebody who nourishes itself from the life vitality of someone else.
So who is sucking this particular thing in the Indian context?
Sir, the large corporate monopolies.
तो इसको आप इकोनॉमिक सर्वे के थ्रू बताओ कि 2019 इकोनॉमिक सर्वे ने बोला था कि इंडिया इज अ विक्टिम ऑफ टू फ्यू कॉर्पोरेट्स और बिग कंपनीज, टू फ्यू एरियाज एंड दे आर जनरेटिंग 99% ऑफ इंडिया जीडीपी, विच इज अ मेजर रीजन बिहाइंड द बबल. इफ इंडिया रियली वॉन्ट टू ग्रो, वी कैन डेवलप एमएसएमई, आर्टिजन कॉटेज एंड स्मॉल यूनिट्स एंड मेक दैम एक्सपोर्ट ओरियंटेड. Only yes. Then we can control this parasite of inequality. Then parasite of inequality is not only the industries. The parasite of inequality is also the patriarchy, gender, rural-urban divide, north-south divide, coastal and inner land divide. All these things are also the part of the that is a parasite of inequality definition of the Oxfam. Okay, what exactly is the India ranking under the Oxfam?
Sir, I am not able to recollect that figure right now.
ठीक है, कोई भी दिक्कत की बात नहीं है. You heard about NMIZ concepts or the NMIZ policy of this country?
Yes, sir. It is about national manufacturing and investment zones in our country. Yeah.
What is the benefit of this national investment and infrastructure zones, and how they are different from SEZ?
Sir, benefit I can recollect. They are about attracting better investment, providing more fiscal incentives and stimulus, job creation and multiplier effect on all the economic parts, better infrastructure.
I do not want generalized point.
Sir, I am not...
Number one, NMIZ is on the industrial corridors. Therefore, they are having backward and forward linkages. Divya, 200 marks ke liye bahut accurate bolna hai. Number two, NMIZ should be constructed only over wasteland. And they can be instrumental in bringing more FDI from Japan and other countries. Number three, they can build both social and physical infrastructure on based on state of the art technology ready to shift part. Green belt is a provision. 24/7 electricity supply. These all are the things. Okay, Divya, nowadays we talks about industrial corridor. And very recently we heard about dedicated freight corridors. If we are having the industrial corridors, why we are having now dedicated freight corridors, and how both are different or complementary to each other?
Sir, industrial corridor connect major economic regions, whereas dedicated freight corridors is in the railway infrastructure sector.
गलत कर दिया starting में. दोनों same हैं. Industrial corridors are based on roads. Dedicated freight corridors based on the railway lines. Both are the part of integrated transportation, but having different responsibilities.
Yes.
Dedicated freight corridor is to decrease the workload on the railway lines. Railway lines are for passengers, and when the goods train are moving on the passenger lines, railway lines, their speed is near to 40, 30, 45, 37 kilometer per hour. Dedicated freight corridor can increase the speed, load, and capacity. Now the one wagon, if suppose they are holding right now 1000 kilogram, after dedicated freight corridor they can hold 1400 kilogram. So the racks which are moving on the dedicated freight corridor having more weights. So lines are building in that manner. Even double decker good trains can move. So the height of the electric line is also very high. Even the normal speed of the goods train movement is around 70 to 80 kilometer per hour, which is not possible right now on the general track.
Yes,
the whole these trains and the hubs are converging at the logistic hub. The first logistic hub we already opened in Assam on the line of east west. There's a corridor in the Assam, some name is there, Anjamani, some name is there, where India first logistic park is developed, which is nothing but the integration of all the transportation method. To is tarike se question puche jayenge to improve karenge, tumhe bhi main do teen kaam de raha hu dobara se, pura Uttar Pradesh acche se karoge, and by evening or by tomorrow we can give you the Uttar Pradesh questions. Clear? I can craft it and mail you. Clear? Just send me your email ID, beta. So we can email you all the questions related to Uttar Pradesh. Now, यू कैन वॉच 4-5 उत्तर प्रदेश वेबसाइट्स. फर्स्ट एनवायरमेंट वेबसाइट ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश, सेकंड इंडस्ट्री वेबसाइट ऑफ द उत्तर प्रदेश, थर्ड वेलफेयर एंड पॉपुलेशन रिलेटेड वेबसाइट. ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन आर क्लियरली गिवन इन द उत्तर प्रदेश वेबसाइट बिकॉज आई एम गाइडिंग द पीपल फॉर पीसीएस ऑल्सो. तो इन वेबसाइट को आप अच्छे से देखेंगे प्लस लास्ट बजट ऑफ द उत्तर प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट. Then 2-3 new steps which they are taken like industrial complexes, labor law reforms in Uttar Pradesh. In par aap jyada focus karoge, pollution, Ganga, clear?
Yes, sir.
Film industry. Then you can focus on Kanpur and the local problem of Kanpur region, locally. To aap lagatar kis par focus karenge? Kanpur par focus karenge.
Yes, sir.
But we can move towards, ek minute rukna. इसके बाद आप उत्तर प्रदेश का कल्चर जरूर पढ़ेंगे और सेंसस पढ़ेंगे, सेंसस और ये पढ़ेंगे. फिर इसके बाद आप तुरंत इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर को करेंगे जो मैंने आपको बोला, और आप एजुकेशन बैकग्राउंड. दिव्या
सर, आई एम बीटेक इन टेक्सटाइल इंजीनियरिंग एंड पीएचडी इन स्ट्रेटजिक अलायंस फ्रॉम आईआईएम लखनऊ.
स्ट्रेटजिक अलायंस?
यस सर.
इट इज इन कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ पॉलिटिकल साइंस?
नो सर, इट्स इन कॉर्पोरेट सेक्टर, बट आई एम होपिंग दैट सम क्वेश्चंस कुड बी थ्रोन माय वे ऑन आईआर आल्सो, सो आई एम प्रिपेयरिंग ऑन दैट.
तो यू कैन डू वन थिंग, प्लीज डू द न्यू टेक्सटाइल पॉलिसी.
यस सर.
टफ्स, TUFS, टेक्नोलॉजी अपग्रेडेशन फंड स्कीम ऑफ टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्री.
Yes, sir.
A major textile hub and their problems.
Yes, sir.
Plus, geotextiles.
Yes, sir.
Then you can also do the company's law and the recent modification the company law because of your strategic alliance type of thing. Even you should know about the new trade policy. Clear, Divya? तो ये सब आप प्रिपेयर करेंगे प्लस द इश्यूज विच वी कैन डिस्कस विद इन दिस 4-5 डेज विद इन दिस सेशन ऑफ पार्लियामेंट. ऑल दिस थिंग्स आई कैन आस्क इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन. इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन आई वांट यू कैन लिसन दिस सेशन 1 or 2 टाइम्स बिफोर कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट सेशन. ठीक है दिव्या?
यस सर.